Today, we're going to be taking a look at the nicest sports classic cars in GTA 5 Online. There is a ton of really nice ones, and they're all pretty cheap as well, and I don't really think that they get the appreciation that they deserve. So we're going to be taking a look at them today. I hope you enjoy the video. Before we get it started, be sure to check out Digazani down below in the description if you guys need any money in GTA 5 Online. With that said, I hope you enjoy, and let's get it started. First up on this list is going to be the Ocelot Swinger. It's based off of a Jaguar XJ13 in real life, and it costs $909,000 in GTA 5. It's a really nice looking car. It's got a few pretty cool looking upgrades. Obviously, it doesn't have a ton of crazy upgrades because it was added a fairly long time ago in the After Hours update. But honestly, this car is pretty cool. One thing I really like about it is that the dashboard is actually a little different than most other cars. The speedometer and the tachometer are actually in the center of the car instead of being right behind the steering wheel, which I thought was kind of cool. And honestly, it just looks like a really cool car, and it doesn't really cost too much money either. It has a few cool customizations, so why would you not want to buy it? Next up on the list is going to be the Turismo Classic. It costs $705,000 on Legendary Motorsports, and it's based off of a Ferrari F40, which is a really nice looking car in real life. One thing that's really cool about this car, it has that V12 engine, and you can have a clear view at it if you guys look at it from the back. Another thing, you can actually make it look really close to how the Ferrari F40 looks in real life. There's a spoiler you can put on it to pretty much make it identical, and I tried to make this one look like how one would look in real life with the black rims, the nice Torino red paint job, and the spoiler on it, and I think it looks really, really cool. I never used to drive around these classic supercars, but I think I'm gonna start because they're pretty damn cool. Next up on this list is going to be the GT500, based off of a Ferrari 250 GT SWB in real life. It looks super nice, and it costs $785,000. It has tons of cool upgrades on it, and it's hands down my favorite Ferrari in the game for the classics and for the normal supercars, just because it looks so nice. You could put a bunch of cool customizations on it and really make it custom and make it your own car. I do wish we had more customization options though for some of these older cars. Nothing extremely crazy, but just a few small things. But I do have to say this car looks really nice, and for $785,000, it's definitely worth it. Next up on this list is going to be the Sterling GT. It costs $985,000 on Legendary Motorsports. It's based off of a Mercedes 300 SL or SLR, and it is a beautiful looking car. One of the best parts about this car is it has tons of upgrades, and another thing, it's also one of the best and fastest sports classic cars in the game. It handles really well, and honestly, it's just the best all-around sports classic car. Obviously, it does have some other competition, but it's definitely in the top three of the best sports classics in the entire game. So if you're looking for a fast sports classic car to use in races or to just drive around in free mode, this car is definitely for you. Next up on this list is going to be the Rapid GT Classic. It's based off of an Aston Martin V8 from the time period of between 1972 and 1989. It will set you back a total of $885,000 on Legendary Motorsports. And can I just say, this car blacked out looks so nice. I also do have to say, pretty much any car in this game looks nice blacked out, but I have to say that this one looks very, very cool. And I love that it is an Aston Martin, just because whenever I think of Aston Martin, I think of James Bond. And honestly, I like how simple this one is. It's just an Aston Martin V8, and it looks so nice in game. It does not have a crazy amount of customizations, but I can just say one thing. It has a crazy exhaust system that you could put on this car. If you guys want to upgrade this thing, go take a look at the exhaust that you could put on this and the engine, and you will see what I'm talking about. But if you want to take a look, you got to go and buy it. I'm telling you, it's worth it. Next up on this list is going to be the Karen 190Z. It's based off a Datsun 240Z, a Nissan Fairlady Z, and a Toyota 2000 GT. I've talked about this car so much, so I'm not going to go into too much detail. It costs $900K on Legendary Motorsports. It has tons of crazy upgrades that you guys can put on it, and it's honestly just a really, really nice looking car in game, which is why tons of people love it. So if you guys are one of those people, definitely buy one. But if you've watched any of my other videos, you probably already own one by now. Next up on this list is going to be the Coke Classic. It's based off of a Corvette Stingray in real life, and it doesn't cost too much in game. It's a pretty cheap car. It only costs $665,000. There is not a lot of upgrades that you guys can put on this car, but I do have to say, it looks so nice in this color that I put it on. It's wine red with a pearlescent of Torino red on it and black muscle rims. This car looks insane. It's not the fastest thing ever, does not have the best handling in the entire game. But honestly, if you guys are fans of classic Corvettes, this car looks amazing. While I was just making this video and driving the car around, I literally sat down at the dinner table when I was eating my dinner with my family and said, I'm going to buy this car after I sell my current car, because that's how nice it is. And I want to make it look just like how it does in game. It looks beautiful and it's definitely a nice car. And like I said, it's pretty cheap, only $665,000. Next up on this list is going to be the Z-Type. I believe it costs $990,000, somewhere around that number. It's actually on sale, and it's been on sale for a while for like $400,000+, which is a pretty good price. This car is based off of a Bugatti Type 57 SC Atlantic, another car that I've talked about a lot, so I'm not really going to go into detail about it. Tons of cool upgrades, looks super nice if you put it in specific color combinations. The one I have on this one, not the best one, but honestly, it doesn't even look bad. And like I said, in past videos, they only made like four of these in real life, and I think there was only about one left, and I think it sold at auction for about $40 million. So pulling up in this thing in GTA 5, you're definitely going to turn some heads if you go to a car show. A lot of people probably won't even know what this car is in real life, so then you could spread some of your knowledge and tell them exactly what it is and how cool it is, and then they're going to want to buy one in game. Next up on this list is going to be the Torero. It's based off of a Lamborghini Countach in real life. In game, it costs $998,000. And in real life, this car looks really awesome. It's the ninth rarest Lamborghini ever made, which is pretty crazy. And obviously, the ones that are rarer are obviously some of the newer ones like the Sesto Elemento and the Centenario and cars like that. But this car in game looks really, really awesome, and it looks cool the way it is. The biggest issue with this car is that it does not have a ton of upgrades. For people that love upgrading cars, then this is probably not for you. But if you're a fan of Lamborghinis and especially classic ones like the Countach, then this car is definitely for you. It does cost a little bit of money for a sports classic car. I think it's one of the most expensive ones on this list, but it is still a really nice car. Next up on this list, or should I say last on this list, is going to be the Mamba. Based off of a Shelby Cobra in real life, this car in game costs $995,000. And I have to say, this is hands down one of the nicest sports classic cars we have in the entire game. The way I customized it, I don't know what it is about this car, but it looks so nice. In real life, you can actually buy one of these for pretty damn cheap. Actually, I should not say cheap. It's still a little shy under $100,000 Canadian, but honestly, that's not a lot of money to some people. So if you guys can afford this thing in real life, then that's pretty awesome. But in game, it has tons of crazy customization options that you guys can put on it. And I would obviously suggest to take the roof off and keep the windshield on. And it looks so cool just like that. It's definitely a really nice sports classic car. And I would highly suggest, out of any sports classic car on this list, to buy this one first. It is one of the more expensive ones at $995,000. But it is still really nice, and I would highly suggest you guys buy it. Anyways, guys, that is going to wrap up the video for today. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, be sure to smash the thumbs up on it. Subscribe if you are new to the channel. And if I missed out on any cars, be sure to comment them down below in the comment section to let some people know. Thank you for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.